This is a podcast all about me.
Your best friend,
Max Gilardi. There's some other guy too, but you don't need to worry about him. He's probably gay. What a faggot, what a loser. No one likes him.
3, 2, 1, fuck it. Welcome to the show. Yo, Tom's not talking to me tonight. Take two.
Wow.
3, 2, 1, fuck it. 3, 2, 1, fuck it. Yo, Tom's not talking to me tonight. Welcome to the show. This is going to be the Max only cast because we're not talking to each other. We're having we're going incommunicado. We're giving each other the silent treatment. So yeah, hope you enjoy that.
My treatment is better because it has a happy ending.
All right.
A regular one, not a sexual one. Don't be weird, Max.
Brackman cast.
What is that? The chat is saying a lot of things about Brackman.
Right. Basically, if you're not listening to the live version of the show, everyone in the chat is talking about Brackman. We want to know what it means.
To be honest, I don't care that much.
I guess I don't care either.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm just curious. I'm sure I won't find it interesting, but I'm kind of just curious.
Guys, I want you to vote on how bad Max did in his intro.
Well, that's why I did take two.
Because I don't think he did very well.
Mm-hmm.
I think he was there.
Mm-hmm.
So, Max, how was your week? Max?
Yeah?
How were your weekdays?
Fine.
What'd you do?
Looked for a job.
Where'd you look for a job for? Where?
I don't understand the question.
What kind of job are you looking for, Max?
A part-time job.
Why, so, you're not ready to commit, Max?
Well, I figure I can do a part-time job, and I can make money that way, and I can spend the other half of my time working on my cartoons and make a little money that way.
And together it's a nice amount of money.
Well, we'll see.
Well, what did you hit up so far?
Ice
cream store?
Okay, I don't see what kind of comment you're making there.
I'm not, I'm asking.
Is that a fat joke?
No. No, it wasn't.
I'm not convinced that it isn't.
It wasn't. A lot of teens work at ice cream shops.
I'm not a teen.
I know. That's why it was funny.
Teens. So you were making fun of me.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Not about your tall weight, though.
Tall weight? Ice.
Yeah.
I don't know what tall weight is.
Because your weight is combined with your tallness.
Tall weight.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know what that means.
Well, Max, are you going to tell me, or are you just going to huff and puff?
I don't know what the question is.
Where'd you look for a job? For a job?
My cat's
all off my table.
She's looking. That's kind of funny.
Yeah, I guess so. She climbed back up like a true champion dom cat.
I am looking at a couple different employment opportunities now. It's hard, though, because not many peoples are hiring part-time. They're all hiring full-time. That's what makes it difficult.
Yeah, and you know the economy.
Right.
Economy's hard over there, right?
Yeah, it is.
I remember when it used to be able to buy a bubble gum for, like, $1.
A bubble gum for $1?
Mm-hmm. A balloon for $3, man, those were the ages.
I would imagine a bubble gum, which I assume would be a pack of gum, would cost about 50 cents. So what, one strip?
Yeah, but it's a good bubble gum.
It would have to be, I guess.
It's really good bubble gum, so it's worth it. So, where'd you look for? Like a grocery store? Bouncy castle.
Bouncy castle. What service could I possibly provide to a bouncy castle? Blow it up?
Yeah, like the backup in case the machine that blows them up breaks, then you're there too.
So they bounce on my stomach?
No. Blow it.
Mm.
Blow it up. Cause ya blow. Shazam. Mm. I thought it was pretty funny. I don't know, but okay. Max, what's wrong? Come on, are you in
the
dumps?
Why are you always attacking me? You're always on the attack, and I don't appreciate it.
I'm not attacking.
Well, it feels like you are.
It's called tough loves.
Oh, yeah? And what type of lesson are you trying to teach me? How are you trying to embetter me?
It's a show on HBO, Tough Love. It's about you, and you have three wives.
No, that's Big Love.
Oh,
or something.
Never mind. Okay,
listen.
Well, yeah.
Listen. You don't... That's what this is about.
I do respect you.
I don't think you do. Everybody thinks I'm a joke. Everyone's laughing at me. And I'm sick of it.
Are you back to that thing, Max? Are you back to being poor little black sheep, Max?
I got to put a stop to it. I have to end it, or else it's never going to cease, and I'll have to carry it for the rest of my life.
I got to show the world
what I can do.
I'll make
them sorry that they ever fucked with me. What do you think of that?
Get a gun and shoot up some places.
Get yourself a gun.
Max, what are you playing today?
I'm playing anything.
I can hear your dumb thumbs.
Dumb thumbs. I'm playing Super Meat Boy, and I'm also wearing a Super Meat Boy t-shirt.
Wow, you're a real Meat Boy fan, huh?
Actually, I don't really like it. I think it's kind of bad.
You're a big fan of the meat.
JK. Nope.
Why don't you like it, and why'd you get a shirt if you don't like it, you weirdo?
I got the shirt just because I need a new shirt. I got the shirt way before I got the game. So
you just
remember
buy shirts
Newgrounds?
You buy shirts of, like, bands you don't even like because you say, like, hey, I need a shirt. I'll buy this Christina Aguilera shirt.
You've jumped to a totally weird conclusion that I don't understand how you could even have gotten there. Just based on the fact that I got a Super Meat Boy shirt before I got the game. Anything else you want to say?
No. I'm done.
Okay. All right.
Last show. Police are coming to get me.
What is that noise?
It's the siren of the police.
Uh-oh.
I know you say fuck the police coming straight from the underground, but here I respect the police. And the
what
cops
did you do?
I help them. I draw like little cute things on their badges.
Well, then why are they coming for you then?
Oh, they just want to get here quickly. Because they're all corrupt.
And they want to come to you so that you can draw things on their badges.
Yeah, they want to spice it up. They want me to bedazzle them.
You'd think that they would have more important things to do, like catching criminals.
Nah, they like bedazzling. They're very fancy cops.
Get yourself a gun.
What are you doing, Max? What? Why are you just
singing
to yourself?
Anything.
You're just singing to yourself. No,
get yourself a gun.
Okay. you know.
I think
what
you're in a bad mood today.
You know what I did a few nights ago?
What'd you do, Yotam?
Usually I end my nights watching something on the computer screen, then sleeping. Right, you do that sometimes, right? You watch a show, go to sleep, take a nap.
I think I do that every night. What do you usually watch? Is it like an internet thing or?
No, usually I watch a show. Right now I'm watching Mad Men.
On DVD?
No, on my computer.
Right. Well,
HD, motherfucker. Jeez.
Okay, but how do you watch it on your computer?
Well, my computer's in my room, and I lay in bed and I watch it from my bed.
Right, but you don't have it on DVD.
But I don't.
Okay, that's just the answer that I wanted to hear.
You knew that. Everyone knew that besides you, Max.
I didn't know that. My initial thought that I jumped to was DVD.
Yeah, because I just buy DVDs, sure.
I know you buy DVDs.
Sure, I love
DVDs. I know you
DVDs.
Buy DVDs.
I never bought a DVD.
I think pretty much everybody owns DVDs.
But I don't buy them. People get them for me.
You know what? All I wanted you to do was... I just wanted you to clarify something, and now you're making a big deal out of it. You could have just answered the question, and I would have said okay, and we could have moved on. But now we're still talking about being an idiot. I don't understand why.
Can we move on, Max? You're harping on this.
I don't know. Can we? I have to ask you that question because you're the one doing that.
Well, it seemed like I asked you first, so I guess I'm the right one in this situation. Yeah. Yeah, Max.
I don't see that logic.
Yeah, because I asked first and you said the same thing, but yeah. Okay, so I was watching WALL-E. Have you seen this movie?
The Pixar film.
Yeah, it's about a robot. Came out like a year ago.
More than a year ago. I would say it's 2 years ago. I really enjoyed it.
Fairly new release. And I decided I'm going to jump on this WALL-E bandwagon.
I don't know if the bandwagon is still going. I think you might have missed the curb on that one.
I don't think so, and I did. And I teared up like a little man boy.
Oh, you've never seen it?
Never seen it!
Well, I would have expected you to see that.
No, I don't like
robots.
Well,
it's pretty good, isn't it?
Yeah, pretty good movie.
Pretty good movie.
Yeah, I mean, I like WALL-E. I like Eve.
I think it's way better than that piece of shit Up, which sucks.
It's about the same. I think Up is funnier.
You know what I call that movie? Fuck Up.
It's pretty good.
But I do like WALL-E.
Up was a lot funnier, though.
Not to me.
Why? Why would you watch
that
movie?
Well, I guess I will concur to that because I don't feel like WALL-E's intention was to be entirely funny.
Yeah, it was.
Do you know what I mean?
A sad movie to make me sad and feel alone.
Okay, I guess we can agree on that. But that's like saying, "Oh yeah, I saw The Godfather. It wasn't very funny." Well, it's not a comedy.
He just wanted to hold her hand, Max.
I know, but you know what? He got to in the end, so it's a happy ending.
I know, but I didn't.
You didn't get to, so you want to hold hands with a robot.
I didn't hold hands with anyone during this. I was hugging a pillow, that's all. And I was I want someone to hold a hand. I want to hold a hand. And then
you gotta get yourself a girlfriend.
Give me a second here, Max. Yeah, so I was like one of the biggest babies.
Yeah, it's a sad one.
It's a sad one, and I was like, it didn't end up like me being like, "Oh, I'm happy now." I'm like, "Ah!" I was like, "No, I'm not happy. You made me sad, WALL-E, you dumb, stupid Asperger robot." He must have had Asperger's, right?
Well, it's got a happy ending, so I don't really know how sad you can be at the end of that movie.
Because he gets everything, and I'm left alone in a bed with my cat.
Oh,
spooning a cat.
I see what this was. I see what this feeling was.
Jealousy of a
the movie made
robot.
You reflect on your own life.
Yeah.
That's what you're saying.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, build a sophisticated robot to be in a committed relationship with.
That's not a bad
idea, that would make
Max.
You feel better?
I think it will. I'll get on that. I'll do what Jeffrey Dahmer did, and I'll start killing little gay boys and try to make a zombie.
That's
what he did.
Look, all I'm saying is...
He poured
know,
formaldehyde into their brains.
Okay, just listen to me for a minute.
Sorry.
We were having a talk about an adorable children's film, and you kind of ruined it.
Oh, yeah, but I also watched, like, America's Most Horrible Dahmers, so...
America's Most Horrible Dahmers. Number one on the list, Jeffrey Dahmer.
Jeffrey Dahmer, yeah, but there are a few more runner-ups. Pretty good.
Listen, all I'm saying is you're sad because you don't have...
I mean, like,
Dahmer
Stevens, like, missed his kid's birthday, so he's a pretty bad Dahmer.
Okay, not funny. Oh, look, all I'm saying is you're sad that you don't have anyone to hug when you watch WALL-E. Why not hug one of your cats?
I do.
They like it.
She bites me.
They like to be hugged.
But then she bites me.
Okay, check it out, cathugs.com.
In association with Pixar Films.
We got hot man on cat action.
It's not very hot, it's more it's cuter than it is hot, but...
I think that's hot.
Yeah. I don't think you do. I think you're... By your response to some ape, I don't think you would be into cat Catman.
Well, it's not cat rape, it's cat hugs. You're just hugging the cat.
Well, you don't know what the cat thinks. You don't know what the cat thinks.
Should hope you're not doing anything more. That's an animal.
It is. That's why I don't feel as bad.
Listen. You listen to me, this guy, Weisenheimer.
Yeah.
That movie's not that sad.
That movie made me real sad, Max. You can't say it's not
sad.
Maybe
you're just a baby. You ever think of that?
Yeah. It's a very plausible possibility that I'm just a baby.
I can't take it upon my responsibility to cheer you up whenever you watch a sad movie. Get over it.
But why not, Max? I'm sad.
Well, we're all sad. That's the human condition. You're sad and you die.
Do you really think so, Max?
I don't
know. Because I saw some shows where some guys were real happy.
Really? What show was that? Fucking Full House with fucking Bob Saget? Is that what you watched and they saw happy people?
Yeah.
Well, you know what, Yo Tom? Cut it out.
Nice one, dude.
Oh, thanks, Uncle Joey.
Man, their dog cleaned all the dishes. I'm surprised that they let him do that. That's gross.
With his tongue?
Yeah.
So he licked them.
Yeah, he licked them clean.
That is pretty gross.
Yeah, I don't know why they would let him do that as a weird anal father. He will just let the dog. I don't know. A lot of plot holes in that show.
Well, it's fictitious, so I probably shouldn't worry too much about it.
Too late. I'm already pretty invested. I'm starting to watch it. Just started watching it. Pretty good. That Kimmy Gibbler, her feet are so stinky. You wouldn't believe it.
That's gross.
Why? That's funny. Her feet are so stinky, man. They're just like... Once she takes them off, everyone goes like, "Pee you!" Oh, and one of the twins goes like, "Dude, surf on!" And... Commercial break. I wish we had commercial breaks, Max.
Alright, let's do one right now.
Okay.
Okay, Weisenheimers will be back after these messages.
Jeffrey Dahmer was an assassin. And you can watch
was
his...
Was an assassin?
Sort of.
I wouldn't say that.
No?
He didn't get paid, so technically no.
I guess not, but he got paid with a... raping... and okay. Such.
Okay.
And we're back! Hey! We talked some things out and we're ready to go. We also decided this is the last show. Cause
oh, sad.
We have some family issues we wish not to talk about, right, Max?
That's right, and it's definitely right.
And it's not because of you guys, it's just because we're...
We're just splitting up.
Yeah, it's time. We just don't click.
Well, you know what? Sometimes mommies and daddies find out that they don't love each other as much as they thought they did to begin with.
Yeah, like my mommy and daddy.
Oh,
father.
Well.
Yeah.
You shouldn't. Mm-mm. Should I guess then?
Yeah, I'm regressing to a place where I'd rather be right now.
Where you'd rather be?
Mm-hmm.
And what place is that?
On a hot air balloon. That'd be kind of nice.
Oh, I don't blame you. Everyone wants to be in a hot air balloon.
Not everyone.
I guess I just want to. Maybe once. I don't know. I don't know if I'd get vertigo or not, but it would be fun to try it just once.
Do you have a history of vertigo?
I am sometimes made to feel uneasy by heights. It's never been a problem, but I don't know.
Well, you gotta get over that, Max. You can't live your life being afraid of heights. Then you can't go climb tall places.
Well, if someone asked me if I wanted to climb a tall place, I would say sure, because I don't have a debilitating fear of heights.
But you have vertigo.
Right, but they're not the same thing.
Vertigo is more dangerous, though. You can just think, oh my god, up is down and down is up. What do I do now? I fall. Chris, you said it happened to me.
I have always wanted to go skydiving.
I don't.
Because then it's like you're falling anyway, so what are you afraid of?
Parachute not opening.
Yeah, but what are the odds of that?
Feeling the boner of another man.
Well, then you're not, like, strapped to another dude. You can just go by yourself.
No, you can't. You need to do some fucking training for that.
No, you don't. I don't need to go training for that because I'm an expert at everything. Oh. But it's like when you're at the top of a building or something and you look down and you feel, like, gross and weird, it's because you're afraid you're going to fall. But if you're skydiving, then you're already falling. So what are you afraid of? Nothing. Oh, yeah. Well, so I would do that in a heartbeat.
Yeah, you want to go skydiving off of a air balloon, hot air balloon?
I think people usually do it from planes. I don't know about that.
Yeah, but we can spice it up.
I don't even know if those hot air balloons get high enough, though.
Oh, we'll get them high enough, Max. We have enough heat between the both of us to get a hot air balloon whatever we want. Body heat. You agree, Max?
Yes.
Thank you.
Do we have any show notes tonight?
Yeah, Max, do you have a bird?
Pet parrot, yeah.
Why the fuck do you have a bird?
We've talked about my parrot before.
I
was talking to Yotam on AIM, and I said something about my parrot, and he was like, what? You have a bird? So that's when do you have a bird? And I was like, we have talked about my parrot. You should already know that I have a parrot, because we have discussed it.
Who the fuck has a parrot? What's wrong with you? Are you a fucking child? Are you a children's classroom? Do you give your other friends a week to have him as well, to take care of him, and then you bring him back to class and someone else gets to have him for that upcoming weekend? Is that the deal with your parrot, Max? I mean, parrots
Email.
Are gay. Parrots are dumb.
I don't see how they're any more dumb than Fett, except that they have the ability to talk, which is pretty cool.
Well, you put a sheet over their cage and they fall asleep because they think it's night. It's good enough for me.
They don't think it's night.
They're
it's just
dumb.
That they can't.
No.
They can't. Wow, you're not even gonna let me talk? Okay, fine.
Okay, I'm sorry, Max.
I'm sorry, too. I'm sorry that you don't want to put on a good show.
Defend your dumb bird.
No.
Your bird's probably a faggot or something.
No, we're just going to sit here in silence because I try to open my mouth to say something and you interrupt me, so you obviously don't want me to talk, so I just won't. So this is just going to be a silence cast.
Sorry, I don't like talking to gay bird owners.
Then why did you bring it up? And why did you even call me tonight to do a show? Because you knew I had a bird.
So I can embarrass you publicly all over the internet? Yeah, you're
being... I think you've only succeeded in embarrassing yourself.
No, I'm pretty proud about myself and my body, so yeah.
Alright.
Max, I'm sorry, I just don't like parrots.
Well, no one's making you have one.
They remind me of the zoo, and I don't like the zoo. Why would I like the zoo? The zoo is not fun. It's not a fun place.
I think a lot of people like the zoo. Why don't you like the zoo?
I don't know. I've seen animals on TV. I don't want to see them up close. I don't care. Looks
well, no one is making you. No one is making you go to a zoo. Likewise, no one is making you own a parrot.
Do you promise me?
Yes.
That's all I wanted to hear, Max. Thanks. I resolved some real issues today. One, I don't have to own a parrot.
Exhausting talking
Two,
to you. It's exhausting.
I don't have to go to the zoo. Whew. Oh, man, I feel like a brick has been lifted off my shoulders, chest, stone. A stone has been lifted off my chest, yeah. That's right, Max?
Alright.
Am I speaking correctly?
Alright.
Max, never mind. You know, Max? I got
what?
Glasses, you know that, Max?
I need this, yeah.
So after a while, your eyesight grows worse. You know that, Max?
I did.
And I decided I should get a new pair of glasses, so I went with a friend of mine to go get glasses.
Alright.
Max, can you please try harder, because...
Try harder to do what?
To participate.
What do you want me to say?
Oh, you have nice eyes.
Oh, you have nice eyes, yo, Tom.
Thanks. And... And I went to the glasses store, and the lady came up and she was like, "So, what kind of glasses do you want?" And I said, "I want these kind of glasses, sort of like that." And we went through a bunch of glasses, and she was very charismatic, and she touched my shoulder, and I was like, "Huh, good, sugoi." And I got the glasses, but then 2 days later, I was like, "These glasses look dumb. The fuck, man!" So I went back with a different friend, a better one. And I got a different pair of glasses.
Mm-hmm.
That's the story about how I got my glasses.
Mm-hmm.
Max, do you have a story to share?
Nope.
I feel like I'm all alone on this.
Hmm.
Well, the glasses I got were pretty good, so... I think I'm gonna get them on Monday, and then I'll see much better, and maybe I'll even look better, because I think they look better than my current ones, because I've had them for about 3 years, and you know with the whole fashion changes, you know how I try and follow every trend and then a new thing coming up, so I get a pair of glasses. But yeah, and I really enjoyed myself purchasing glasses with my friends.
Mm.
Max, you gotta help me out here. I feel like I'm on a boat by myself and sinking, and you're just being dead weight. You're just being dead static weight.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Okay, I invented a new smiley. I want to teach you all how to use it, and I use it in their daily conversations. It goes like this: it's a question mark, and then it's those two dots. How do you call that, Max?
Semicolon.
Semicolon. That, yeah, and then you put a dash for a cute little nose. And then you do a face or a sad face. That's up to you. You can go crazy with that. I don't mind. You can make him happy. You can make him sad. You can... A lot of choices. But at the end, after that, you need to add a 3 at the end. So it's like he has a butt chin, his hair, and he looks cool. So that's my smiley trademark, your Tom Perl. And I think you should all start using it. Let me know what you guys think about my smiley. What do you think about my smile, Max?
Good.
You really think so? Because you told me not to do it when I was talking to you earlier.
Oh.
Are you enjoying the game?
No. I already said I don't like this game.
Why are you playing it then?
Oh, because I bought it, so I might as well play it.
Hmm. That's not how a winner thinks, Max.
Well, then what do you want me to think?
Just say, "Hey, this game is hack. Is hacking my Xbox. I want my points back."
You can't get refunds though, which is unfortunate.
Just say, "I've been hacked."
I'd be lying.
Who cares, man? Come on. Think like a winner. Saying,
winners never
hacked,
prosper.
I'm trying to play the game, but it doesn't work. I've been hacked. I'm getting all sort of weird pop-ups on my AOL account.
And, my AOL account isn't linked to my Xbox account.
Well, link it then. Come on, man. We're trying to pull a sting here.
I don't think they link.
Oh. Well, my TV is starting to get a lot of pop-ups, like, hey, I'm a girl, I want to make love to you, where are you from? And I know that's not a genuine girl because it's on my TV and there's no way a girl can come out of my TV. unless it's that girl from The Ring. You know that girl? She's fucking spooky, man.
Well, you say spooky, I say kind of hot.
Yeah, you like her sores.
Mm-hmm.
And her scabby skin. She looks like Charles Bukowski.
Mm-hmm.
That was funny, man, what I said.
Woof! It sure was.
Man, I'm on a roll here. I can feel my pecs flexing.
That's disgusting.
I can feel myself starting to juice up, if you know what I mean. Juice up, Max. Okay, Max has a bird, your Tom glasses adventure, your Tom smiley, tearing up watching Wally.
What are you doing?
Look at my show notes. I'm out of show notes, because Max refused to participate in my adventure. And it's not doing
well,
anything.
You know what? Is it Max refuses to participate or Yotam refuses to let him?
I'm pretty sure it's the latter. I mean, it's the first.
No, I'm pretty sure you were right the first
no,
time.
No. I just wanted to sound smart saying a word that I don't usually use.
You should have said the prior then, which is the opposite of the latter.
Well, yeah, whatever. So, Max, what do you have to talk about? I'm sure it'll be interesting.
I have nothing.
Okay, so I'm going to take chat requests, because I guess this is what we do now. Talk about Quentin Tarantino. I like some of his movies, I found a lot of them boring.
I like some of his movies, the other ones of his movies I don't like.
Yeah, so I'm fair and balanced. Like
that's basically
News.
How I feel about every director.
No, all of the movies of Christopher Urban Murdy. I thought that Inglourious Basterds was a really good movie. It was my favorite movie of 09, possibly.
I like Kill Bill, Volume 1. Never seen Volume 2.
Why? It's a good movie.
What if it sucks, though? Then I will not like Volume 1 as much, because I'll know that it has a lousy sequel.
I know, but it's a good movie, man.
Well, maybe someday I'll see it. Not today, though.
Too bad, because I got a free ticket for you and me.
It's not in theaters.
Oh, right. Forgot about that. Let's talk about the contest.
I like the movie Tron.
I haven't seen it.
No. Well, I would suggest that you don't.
Okay. Let's talk about the contest, Max.
All right. We're having a contest.
Let's do the jingle.
Yo, we got a contest. Everyone should enter. And if you don't enter, we'll beat the shit out of you.
Okay, and sorry, we're doing a running contest in which you, my baby, need to make an animation, taking audio from this podcast right now, and you take it and you can lip sync to it, you can make a song with it, you can make video, you can make claymation, you can make 3D digital drawings, you can sketch it on a wall, you can use an extra sketch.
3D digital drawings.
Thanks.
But since when can they make a song with it?
Swear fucking, I don't know, do whatever.
That's news to me.
We'll decide when the winner gets. The winner gets, what do they get, Max?
My dick in their butt.
That's not true. You're getting season 3 of Team and Eric, season 3, vandalized by me. With my name, and my sperm maybe, depends on a lot of
your
things.
Sperm?
Maybe.
I thought you said spur for a minute.
Oh,
like you're
no.
A cowboy? And you're going to take the spur off the shoe.
No. I don't even... I wouldn't do that.
Sperm.
If they want me to.
That seems kind of unsanitary. And also in extremely poor taste.
Well, you never had my sperm because it's not poor and it's not tasty, so.
Mm. Can we just end this contest already?
They have another month, Max. Just kidding. You have 3 more weeks to finish it. You have 3
We've been
more
giving
weeks.
Them another month for about 10 months now.
I know, but I gave them 3 more weeks now.
But
okay.
I don't even. But you know what? I don't even know if it's worth it because I feel like in those 3 more weeks we're probably not going to get any more entries. Except
well, too
for maybe,
bad, Max. I promised something,
for maybe
and I'm
one.
And I'm a man, and I trust people. I'm a trustworthy man.
I think we should just name a winner.
No, because people are working hard.
You know what? How about let's do this? Can we do something? Can we agree on this? Can we reach an impasse? And make a compromise?
I don't know. Let me know what your idea is.
We ask them, are you working on something for the contest, or are you at least planning on working on something for the contest? If we get back 3 people who say yes, then we'll continue it.
There are 2 people here that are saying that they're working on something, and I also got a PM on Newgrounds of someone saying that he's working on something.
All right, fine.
Bam!
Okay, we'll go for 3 more weeks.
You
proved me wrong, and I will allow 3 more weeks in that case. I honestly didn't think we were going to get any more. Because we haven't gotten any in a while.
Mm-hmm. 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 Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know.
So, Max, you know, I went out yesterday.
Oh, jeez.
What?
Here we go with another one of your stories.
It's a true story. What?
I know, your stories are true. That's the unfortunate part, because you think true equals interesting, but it doesn't.
Okay.
Yo, Tom, I went out the other day, and I saw a little baby cat in the street, and I said, hi, little baby cat, and he gave me a little kiss on the nose, and then I went home, and I said, okay, I'm going to go to sleep now, baby cat, goodbye, sagoy, and I went to sleep. Okay, goodbye, babies!
Well, Max, this is nothing like the story. Well, I have a grasshopper on my wall, and it just stayed there for...
I think the story is similar.
It just stayed there for, like, 2 days. I was like, what the fuck are you doing here, you stupid grasshopper? Get off my wall. And I was like, when are you going to go away from here?
So it was my story, except with a grasshopper instead of a cat.
Yeah, I guess so. But it didn't kiss me on the nose. Kiss me
maybe
on the inner thigh.
Give me a little kiss on the nose.
Yeah.
Was it like the grasshopper from James and the Giant Peach? Did it play a violin?
Yeah, if a violin's my dick.
Okay.
Oh, well, I'm going to tell you an actual story now that I was about to tell you.
So the grasshopper one wasn't your story?
It was a story. It did happen, but it wasn't the story.
But that
I was
wasn't
about
the story
to
you were going to tell?
No.
Okay.
I went over to my friend's house, Roy.
All right.
And we.
Now, who's your friend?
What do you mean, who's my friend?
Tell me who your friend.
It's Roy, man. He's a good friend.
That's sufficient enough.
I said that, but you didn't listen. And we sat in his room. We watched some. We watched the latest episode of The Office. You know that you heard of this show?
Yeah.
It's with Steve Carell. Mm-hmm. Carl Earl. And Pam Jim. Good show. Mm-hmm. And I was having a beer. He was having a beer. 2 beers. Good beers.
All right.
Great beers. Then afterwards, we said, like, hey, okay, let's go out and do something. And then I went to the bathroom, and I peed, of course, as I do in the bathroom.
This doesn't seem like something that you should put in the story.
This is the story. I peed.
The fact that you're peeing in the bathroom?
Yeah. I peed, and then I went over to wash my hands. And, like, when I peed, you know, I looked at my stream. It was a nice, constant stream.
Okay.
It hit
yo,
the bowl.
Tom.
It was like, and everything. It had everything. And then when I went over to wash my hands, I noticed I completely peed my pants.
What?
And to this, I still have no idea how this happened.
You peed on your pants.
I peed all over from my dick to the end of the pants leg, just a long stream of urine. And I was like, how the fuck did this happen? And I need someone to help me out. I need someone to CSI this and let me know how this could happen.
There's an episode of Wacky Game Jokes where Mickey pees on his shirt. Remember this?
Yeah.
The reason that that's in the episode is because one day I was peeing, and I looked down, and I realized I was peeing on my shirt, and I said, ah, fuck, I peed on my shirt. And then I thought, you know what? I should put that in a cartoon. And I did. So that was actually a true story.
I have no idea how that happened, and I was so ashamed.
Well, sometimes you just don't... You don't really pay attention.
But I did pay attention. I looked down and I saw it hit the bowl.
I don't want to hear you about you looking down at yourself.
But
while
that's
you pee,
the thing.
That's kind of gross.
The only thing I could imagine is maybe I had like a thin hair on the tip of my pee hole. And then my pee stream. This happens to you, right? Sometimes.
You know. Wait a minute. Let me ask you a question.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully this won't venture into too much information territory. Was this recently after you had ejaculated?
No, I know what you mean, but no, because I was at my friend's house and we didn't jerk off each other that time.
So if you jerk off, you have to clean the tip of your dick because the semen will like cement your dick shut.
Yeah, I know, but it wasn't that. It wasn't that.
All right.
So I'm just assuming that there was. Thank you. There was a hair on the tip of my penis, I guess, and it just went all places.
Okay, and now, new subject, because I don't want to talk about this anymore.
And I dried it off, and I put some deodorant on it, and I was good as new.
What did your friend say? You're like, dude, what happened? You pee yourself?
I was like, I peed myself, and he was like, ha! And then he helped me out.
What do you mean he helped you out? Or do I even want to know?
He blew on it real close by. No, he gave me, like, towels and everything.
He didn't give you a fresh pair of pants?
No.
Oh, what's some friend, huh?
Well, we don't wear the same size.
Why not?
Because he's a tall man and I'm a short man.
Then the pants would just be long on you. He could give you a pair of shorts, and they would be... He could give you a pair of shorts, and on him they would be shorts, but on you they would be pants. Check it out, arjunpoopy.com.
What will they do next? Okay, so that was a lot of show notes, and
that was that last story. I have to confess, not that bad. Honestly, not that bad.
Thank you. You didn't like the glasses story when I went and got glasses, and then
no,
I said, like,
no,
these are not good glasses, and I went back and I got glasses that are better.
What made you think that would be interesting?
I thought you'd be interested in my eyesight. I thought you would care.
No. Unless it's like it turns funny in some way at some point, then no.
I thought it was pretty funny that I had to get new glasses. It's kind of funny.
I don't understand why that would be funny to you.
Well, whatever.
You know, sometimes I don't think you know how to do a podcast.
Well, sometimes I think all you do is just sit there and play while I do all the hard lifting.
I am the one who usually has to carry the show. And today, I don't
really
feel like...
Yeah, right.
I'm not really doing it tonight, usually it's me.
I'm like Wayne, and you're the other guy, the guy with the yellow hair world. You're that guy. I'm Wayne. I'm the strong one, and you're just a weird nerd.
I'm not familiar with that content.
Wayne's World?
No, I've never seen that movie or any of the sketches on SNL, unfortunately. Maybe someday.
Well, but I'm the cool guy and you're not, so... That's... Hey, Max.
Yeah?
You smell that?
I hope not.
Emails!
Oh, boy.
This is from JB. What's your favorite sexual position? Max?
Next email.
Okay,
next email.
Hey, I know what you're trying to get out of me, but I won't say it.
What?
I think it's like a stupid meme. Like, hey, what's your favorite sexual position? The missionary and purpose of something something. And then they go like, gross. High five.
I prefer cowgirl.
This reverse?
No, not reverse.
Yeah, that's
regular cowgirl. I think reverse is stupid.
Okay. Duke Lavia.
I mean, I guess it's okay because you're still having sex, but...
Yeah. Let's next email. The camera, I guess. Hey guys, what are you planning for Halloween? Any costume ideas? Max, I really liked your entry for Mega 64 contest.
Oh, thank you. I get to find out tomorrow if I won or not.
Probably not, though.
Why do you say that?
So, what'd you dress? Any costume ideas, Max?
Nope, didn't dress up.
Me neither. But once Pareem shows, I will put on the spiffiest tie I have.
Next email. Why are we answering an Halloween email today? That was last week.
This is from Jesse Anonymous. Have you ever noticed that your personalities, at least on your show, correspond with your art styles and your animations? Your tummy's more calm and let back. Let back? Laid back, I guess. And his animations have more variations in line of thickness, and he's more willing to go off model. She's basically saying that I cannot keep a proportion. I cannot keep my proportions right, and I'm bad. Max, on the other hand, a little more serious and uptight. And his animations, line and thickness are always consistent. His characters rarely, if ever, go off model. I'm not saying this one art style is better than the other, as both of them.
I am. I'm saying that.
Me too, to be honest. Animating styles look perfectly fine. I just think it would be interesting to point out. Yeah, it's just him being a lot more organized than me, and it's probably better to be organized like he is.
Well, you're really pimping out that pilot. I know you are.
I'm trying.
Giving it your all.
Giving it the best I can. Once I finish that, I'll be so happy and want to see what they think about it.
When do I at least get to see part one?
You know, it's just annoying because it's the flaw? Is that how you say that? Flaw? F-L-A. Oh god, I just joked.
I don't know what you're saying, so...
Talk to people!
Hi everybody, my name's Max. I'm the co-host of this show. Yo Tom, I think has something stuck in his throat right now.
Okay, that's back. I got a toad. A raped toad. You know, toad throat? Is that something?
No, that's the thing.
I got a toad in my throat.
Okay.
Okay.
That works a little better.
What was I saying? Sorry.
I don't remember.
Oh, the acts. I have the animations like split to a bunch of different files. And the Swift files, I need to somehow get them into one consistent... It's annoying, and for some reason, After Effects doesn't do the job.
I think maybe you're just not doing it right.
Hey, Lolalala. Hey, guys. Are you majoring on something, studying in a community college, or staying at home?
Do you plan I'm sorry, I didn't hear the question.
Are you majoring on something?
Majoring?
Oh, majoring.
Majoring.
Mayoring. I'm the mayor of animation!
I'm the mayor of Kookie Land!
Are you majoring on something, studying in a community college, or staying at home?
I'm Maxwell Edison, majoring in Madison!
Da 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 da! That animation of yours is so cute. Who is better, Hitler or Hussein?
Hussein?
Hussein. Okay, I'll say it in Hebrew.
Next email.
Hussein.
See, now this is the kind of email that when you filter through them, you would exclude.
Oh, okay. Okay, let's try this one. Miki Shirkowski. Shirkowski, nice. Hello, Jack and you, Tom. I'm a big fan of your show. Just started listening to the other day.
You really did call me Jack?
Yeah. The other day because a friend told me to watch it. Watch it, whatever. I like love Chocolate Man, and I just started watching Wacky Game Jokes for Kids. I really think Mickey is really funny and kind of weird sometimes.
He said that?
Yeah. Anyways,
well,
I have a question, friend.
I
have a question for each of you. Tom, when can we expect a Nameless with Creeper Boy and Chocolate Man? And Jack, is the guy who does the voice for Eric in Wacky Game Jokes the same guy who does the voice of Smithers for The Simpsons?
I don't know who you're talking to. I don't know who Jack is. So I can't find this Jack and have him answer the question for you. Sorry.
Okay, and when will we get a new Nameless? I don't know. Maybe tomorrow.
Do you think you might ever want to do another Nameless?
I hope I'll get that surge of adrenaline to... reunite my two best friends.
Hmm, cute.
Thanks.
So what kind of chocolate is he?
Magical chocolate.
Oh. Yeah. How come he has a robot's voice? He's made of chocolate.
Just how he was born.
Hmm. How come he doesn't have a penis?
He does. But he molds it. He molds it first if he knows he's going to have sexual intercourse.
Oh. Well, I just would imagine, since he's Chocolate Man, and he's obviously fully nude, I don't understand why you'd call him Chocolate Man if he doesn't have a penis. And he clearly doesn't.
Well, first of all, he has the voice of a strong man.
Second, I guess,
all,
but...
He doesn't have hair, which makes him automatically a guy.
But those aren't the defining characteristics of male.
If he had eyelashes, he would be a girl. But he doesn't. So
maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe, yo, Tom, maybe.
You guys are the bee's knees or whatever the pun is. It's not a pun, but okay. What would you prefer to do? What would I have to do to get on your show? Please give me a list of things that would impress you guys enough to talk to you guys. Just nothing illegal or involving baby sex or anything that involves my penis. I would myself doing these things.
Next email.
Why? Why? We can tell him to do stuff.
Like what? Punch yourself in the face.
Take a walk. Jog.
take a jog.
Eat vegetables.
Take a click.
Take care of yourself, Dustin, okay?
Dustin Diamond.
P.S. Max is funnier, but your Tom's voice wins everything.
I concur with that.
Thanks. Wait, that's mean.
Why does that mean?
I don't know, because you just said I'm funnier in that.
We both have our talents. I wish I had a hilarious voice.
Yours is to be funny, and mine is to make silly voices.
You know what? Son. Make silly voices.
Well, you do.
Not often, though.
In June. Yeah. No, it doesn't really pass through your brain a lot, just like sometimes. This is from Liam Donnelly.
Liam Neeson?
Max! Was your entry to the Scott Pilgrim contest disqualified, or were you just not chosen as a finalist? I thought I remembered you saying something about being disqualified. I'm not really sure.
If Why would
you
I be
were...
disqualified?
I don't know.
Because I don't like Scott Pilgrim?
I don't know. I don't know why he would say that. Maybe you... maybe we're dumb or something. Here, Tom, after production of the pilot is finished, you should accidentally send it to Max, who will accidentally upload it to some obscure corner of the internet and accidentally give us all a series of clues to find it.
Well, he won't be accidentally sending it to me. He will be purposefully sending it to me.
Yeah.
But I won't be uploading it to the internet, sorry.
Thanks.
Because I'm a good friend.
And then he attached a picture of a really old guy, and it's called Your Tom 20 Years Later.
Oh, wow.
And I don't know if he thinks I'm 60 years old, but I don't think it will... I don't think I will have white hair when I'm 40. When I'm 40? No, 39. I don't think I'll have a...
nice
I'll
math, go. Genius.
I don't think... I don't know, but he does look pretty good, though. He has nice hair for his age. Good job, whatever, whoever you are,
good job,
old man.
Danny.
This is another email from Dustin.
No speak. It's another thing we gotta do. You know what? I'll just do the emails next week, and perhaps forever, because you can't handle it.
You don't know me.
Well, you dropped the ball tonight.
He sent us a drawing, a fan art drawing.
All right, let's see it.
Look at it.
I can't see it. Send it to me on AIM.
He drew He drew me like a Mexican.
Let's see how ugly he drew me, because that seems to be the trope
people
do. No,
he drew pretty well. I think, Max. What do you think?
It's not loaded yet. Hang on. Oh, okay. That's not bad. That's not bad.
You got weird eyes, but you know, so do I.
My beard isn't that big, unfortunately.
Yeah, you wish it was. This is from Matty Gilchlark.
That's a bad kind of beard, one that's too big. Mine is very underplayed.
Matty, I just shaved today, so that's good. Hey, Tom, I just found out an update on that thing you asked me. It's true that Max is uncircumcised. What?
What?
But shut up, Matt. Maddie, fuck you.
Maddie, no more emails from you ever.
Don't talk about his dick, okay? Only
so
I
inappropriate.
Get to. Right, Max?
Where did she even get that fact? Is that leaked somewhere? Because I've never said that.
It's on TMZ.com.
And I think we've also established on this show that we are, in fact, both circumcised. So.
We have? Nice.
Yeah.
We can dock, but I guess we'll be fine without it. This is from Alicia Vickery.
Next email.
This is from Alicia Vickery. Dear Tom and Max, I've been listening to the pod and enjoying it. The pod, I like that. I listen to it at work and it saves my night. I have a question for your Tom. Ooh, she works. Ooh.
It's her job, is my first question.
Yeah, what's your job, Alicia? I followed Tom and Divinov for years and was around when he announced he was going into the army. At the time, I offered him to marry me so he can come to the U.S. and he wouldn't have to be in the army. It's a story my flesh tomb loving friends and my Jewish friends find very amusing. I was just wondering, does Tom remember that? Well, I get a lot of marriage proposals. I can't keep them all down, but sure, of course, you were the special one.
That's very nice of
him. You were the special one. Although I don't think I would marry someone just for that. I need to feel.
Would you if you had to? Would you if you were going to the army and you had to fight?
Well, I got my things and I know how to get out of things, you know? Because I'm a hustler.
I don't know what that means.
I'm a hustler. It's from Christina Martin. Martin, do you have any Martins?
What is this, all names? Questions from Chicks Cast?
Oh, yeah, it is. Waka waka waka. Hey guys, again, I had the question just pop in my head, so here it goes. Say, I'm not a good reader, I'm sorry.
Yeah, another reason why I should be doing this.
For some odd but cool reason, a huge company like Mr. Fox or ABC123 wanted you to animate a little thingy for them, like your Tom situation. Okay. And you even got well-known, actors to voice in your cartoons. Okay, sounds awesome. Here's the catch. The actors are ones you happen to really hate or just can't stomach. And you're collaborating with Seth MacFarlane.
Is this question geared towards me specifically?
Sorry if this question doesn't make any sense. In reality, it probably wouldn't happen, but I would like to know your reaction would be to that kind of situation. I don't know if I had a cast that I hate.
I don't think I'd be able to have a cast that I hate because there's really no one or no really actors that I don't like.
Yeah.
I'm not a fan of the stuff that Seth MacFarlane makes, but it's not like I know the guy personally and I don't like him.
Yeah,
I'm sure he's friendly.
He's got a cute face.
He's cute. I will concur to that.
Yeah. And he sings well.
He does. He's a very good singer, and he writes good music too.
Mm-hmm,
I think he should move to Broadway.
He's
do
a
Broadway
talented
music.
Guy. Talented guy. Okay, I don't want to read this.
That's what you should have said during all of them tonight. So wait, what was the question? We didn't answer it.
How would you feel if that was the case? I would be like, this sucks, and keep working.
I would do it.
And then some guy's telling me how I should pay you.
How who should pay who?
How I should pay you for doing backgrounds.
He already paid me. Why, what was his suggestion?
Let's read it. I think that if the show spools through, you should give Max a final payment generally higher than what he was getting for his work as a background artist, or give Max royalties because he helped you with the script. And maybe he can continue if the show pulls through. I don't know why you think he helped me with the script, because he
didn't help him with the script. I think it would have been a lot better if I'd helped him with the script. That's right, I said it.
Maybe it was, maybe it would be, but I will never know.
Say that, read what he wrote again. Say what he wrote.
If it pulls through, then I should pay you more. I don't know.
Oh, no, of course not.
No, that's dumb. What is the worst gift you to ever receive?
Wait a minute. He did say that you should be giving me a job if this does go to a series, and I concur with that totally.
I think that if it does, I don't think that'll be up to me, but I'll try.
But what I'm saying is, if it is up to you,
oh,
in the
Max,
event that
you just won't leave me alone about that.
I want you to just say that you will, but you won't.
I will never. I will never promise you a job.
If
never,
you
Max.
Have the option to, why wouldn't you?
Because I'm a man, and I don't like promising when I know that it's not 100% sure that I will do that.
But why wouldn't you? I don't understand.
I don't know! There are gonna be so many more variables that we can't talk about right now.
All I'm saying is, if I had the option to give you a job... So that's this is already hypothetical, because I understand that you don't know if it will be up to you. But in the hypothetical situation in which I have the option to give you a job, of course I would. Of course I would.
Thanks,
Yo, Tom.
Max.
But apparently you don't feel that way about me.
It's not that I don't feel that way. I just don't like promising. I can promise you that I'll try my best. Is that good, Max?
No, it's not.
Who's my little background artist? Who does background art for me?
You said that you thought that I did a good job and that you liked
you
the background.
You did a great job. Who's the best background artist
What's
ever?
What's the problem?
I just don't like promising things, that's all.
And every time I put out a new Wacky Game Jokes, you say that you like it and you say that you like my cartoons.
I do. I'm not
you
lying.
You know that I am capable of making things and that I am capable of performing this task. Basically, I would be the perfect employee to hire.
But
you
if,
know that
if they say, okay, you have one more guy to hire for your staff, and I already have a few people that I want, and they're the guy,
why wouldn't you hire me first, though?
And they're gonna go, so it's a fucking David Cross or Max Gilardi. Who do you think would be a better writer for you? I don't know. I'll have to consider some things.
Okay, well, you can't get... You think you're going to get David Cross? No, he's
I'm
not
sure
going to
come. Sure I will. I promise
no,
you he will.
Not. You're going to say, David Cross, will you come write a show with me? And he's going to say, who are you? I don't know who you are.
I'll
That's
tell
what's
going to
happen.
I'll tell him I'm a big fan of Mr. Show, and he'll be like, aw, I love you. Are you okay, Max?
No. I can't believe this. You're
Max,
unbelievable.
I can't offer the world up for you.
I'm not offering... I don't want the world. Just want one measly position on your show.
Max, what's the worst gift you ever got, Tin?
A bottle of shampoo on Christmas for my grandmother.
That's a great gift.
No, I mean... Thanks, Grandma. You know me so well.
Wow. That's awful.
Oh yeah, it is.
Man, I don't remember any bad gifts I got. I know that, like, my grandmother got her daughter my cousin, uncle or cousin. I'm not sure.
Your grandmother's daughter would be your mother, or your aunt.
My aunt, yeah. My aunt, she got her a scale once for when she
was
younger.
That's not bad if she knew that she wanted it.
No, it was just a very, very... It was just like a passive-aggressive hint. Yeah. But no, I don't think I've gotten anything. Nothing memorable, really. shampoo. It's nice. Hope you guys love it. Peace and love, Denny Tames. Cartoon for the contest. Nice. We got a cartoon, man.
Really? Have I seen it?
I don't know. I think so. Yeah, I think it's the one that I... Which one is it? Yeah, I watched this one. I remember this one. Hey, how's it going, you guys? I know Max plays a lot of video games and Tom plays some as well. My question is, what's your favorite type of video game? Huh? What is, Max?
That's a good question, actually.
Yeah, that's too hard for me. I like a lot of games from different
genres. Yeah, I do too. I like adventure games, which
I
know is kind
of
a broad term, but I do enjoy going on adventures.
Someone made a pumpkin of, covered a pumpkin of Mickey the Dick.
I saw it. It was very cool.
Looks like he
There was
a
also
beard.
A Jerry pumpkin. Mickey
See,
does have a beer.
You have the most popular shows, Max, and you feel so sad. You gotta cheer up, Max. Cheer up!
Mickey the Dick does have a beard.
What? He doesn't. It's not really a beard.
What would you call that?
It's like a goatee.
Goatee goes around your mouth, though.
Doesn't have to.
Actually, in season 2, all the characters are redesigned, and Mickey the Dick might have a different beard.
Nice. Will he have a normal chin? Boom!
He's had a normal chin since episode 3, so clearly you don't know what you're talking about.
Guess so. If you could choose a way to die and where to die, where would it be and why? If you could choose a way to die, where to die, where would it be and why?
In my sleep, dur.
Yeah, in my sleep, or in my bed, in a whore's bed.
Or sinking into lava, and then I give the thumbs up.
That sounds kind of painful.
Yeah, but, you know, it'll be over quick enough.
I wanna be strangled by a bear.
I don't want that. That sounds,
in a castle.
Painful.
In a castle, yeah.
In the castle, Grayskull.
Cool. And that's it for today, guys.
Really?
Yep. Remember to breathe.
Spay and neuter your pets.
Drink. Live healthy.
Eat, pray, love.
Yeah. But, you know, if you want to do those things, you better eat less and pray for more love.
Check it out, Oprah.com.
Remix! Just kidding, this is Because by the Beatles. Check it!